Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Daily Doc Talk. I am your host, Dr. Drew Timmermans. So last week I had posted an Instagram post talking about occipital neuritis and kind of some of the underlying causes that you can have, one of those being neurogenic inflammation coming from the greater and lesser occipital nerves as they pierce through the deep cervical fascia and then wrap around kind of the back of the head and up the back of the skull. And so just to recap, in case you didn't see that, when you have fascial entrapments around a nerve, you can get a buildup of nerve growth factor, which then causes some neurogenic inflammation. And then you have the TRPV1 ion channels that then spit out substance P and CGRP, two peptides that are going to be heavily involved in both your perception of pain, but also in local degeneration and local calcification in that area. And so as those nerves pierce through the different layers, as they're coming out from the spine and the cervical cord, you can have, the spinal cord, you can have entrapment in those deeper layers and in the superficial layers of fascia. And then that can cause that neurogenic inflammation, which then causes a headache. And so one of the questions I had, I just wanted to shoot a video for because I thought it was a really good and interesting talking point. And so the question that I got asked was, if a specific chiropractic adjustment to the C1, C2 cervical vertebrae, if that could help to decrease muscular tension, if they were, if the joints were misaligned, could that improve the muscular tension in the area, which could then reduce the tension on the nerves and then therefore reduce the neurogenic inflammation and therefore the headaches? And so to properly answer that question, it's important to kind of give you my framework on how I view joint manipulations and chiropractic adjustments and things like that, because it just might be a more encompassing view than some of you are accustomed to. And so depending on who you talk to, there's going to be certain groups of people who are going to believe that the joints are the initial insult, and so those are the initial place where the subluxation or the misalignment or the restriction or fixation occurs, and then the musculatures around respond to that joint, and then that creates that tension around the joint. If you look at, and then the other camp is going to be that the muscular system has, and fascial system more so, the myofascial system has tension throughout it, which can then cause fixations in the joints or a slight misalignment or anything like that. And so I believe both can occur, and I think it's not all one and it's not all the other. It depends on a patient. So if a patient has been in a recent motor vehicle accident or they recently fell or something like that, I think there's a higher likelihood that the joints themselves are the initial insult and they're fixated or restricted and the musculature around it responds by tensing up. But on the other hand, if it's been a long-term chronic just wear and tear thing, the chances are more likely that it's a myofascial issue as the initial insult causing the hypertonicity and the restricted movement in the joints. And so they end up having a fixated movement or anything like that. And so so that's kind of the first thing, is to differentiate between those two, because if you've been following me for a while, you know that I want to get as close to, or if not get to, the root cause as possible when treating, because patients typically tend to have a better outcome that's longer lasting because of that. And so if the if it's the myofascial system that is that has the hypertonicity and is clamping down and causing the restriction in the facet joints, for example, in the cervical spine, then just going in and doing an adjustment, even if it's a specific adjustment to the C1, C2 vertebra, for example, may provide some temporary relief, and it may actually help reset the hypertonicity of those muscles in the area. But if it doesn't, then that tension and that pain can just come back, because we didn't address the initial, the more root cause area, which was the myofascial system. On the other hand, if the joint is fixated because of a motor vehicle accident or anything like that, where the initial insult or cause is more so the actual joint, then if we're just doing things to address the soft tissue and we're not adding in that manipulation of the joint aspect, then we still might not get the results, the long-term results that we're looking for, just because we're not getting to that initial insult and that initial root cause. So now that you have all that framework, going back to the question on, can a specific C1, C2 adjustment help to release myofascial tension in the area and then reduce the tension around the nerves? And the answer is it can. It depends on which kind of avenue we're dealing with. Are we dealing with the joint fixation is the primary insult, the primary culprit of the myofascial tension, or is the myofascial tension the culprit of the joint fixation? If the myofascial tension is the culprit of the joint fixation, then the specific chiropractic adjustment may or may not help with the decrease in tension long enough to allow that nerve inflammation to come down in order for pain to decrease and resolve the headaches in the long term. Because the other kind of layer to this is that when you have nerve inflammation, that nerve is not functioning the way it should be, and therefore the muscles that it innervates are not functioning the way they should be. And so even if you have a sensory nerve that has been encased in the, or trapped in the fascia, and that's causing a buildup of inflammation, then that can feed back into the motor nerves that branch off a little bit more proximal or closer to the spinal cord. And then that can impede and affect the motor units that are going out to the muscles. And so the neurogenic inflammation can therefore affect the motor recruitment and the hypertonicity of the surrounding musculature. And so if the neurogenic inflammation doesn't go away long enough, then the adjustments may not help long term with the neurogenic inflammation and the headaches, but they still may. There's no black or white in medicine. It's a spectrum, it's a gradient, and there's a lot of different things that go into, outcomes and things like that. And again, this is all predicated on our assumption for this question that the headaches are coming from the occipital nerve for the occipital neuritis as it's coming out of the superficial and the deep fascia. If these were headaches that were coming from the C1, C2 facet joint, for example, then a combination of some soft tissue work with a specific manipulation to that area could prove really beneficial and could provide long-lasting results for those type of headaches. And so, again, this is something I've talked about a lot before, is, the right therapy is the right therapy because it's the right therapy. And what I mean by that is chiropractic may or may not work for every single patient that walks through the door. The therapies that I do may or may not work for every person, every patient who walks through my door. And then the same applies for DOs, physical therapists, MDs. Every medical field has an area that it does really well in. And I think over the next 100 years, we're really going to parse that out and figure out, how do we kind of not precondition, but how do we try to better determine who's going to be a good responder for surgery, who's going to be a good responder for mainly chiropractic, or some integration of all of that. And so, that's just kind of how I approach these things and how I think of these things. Also, when I have a patient who's a non-responder, whether it's to my therapy or a different type of therapy, these are the things that go through my mind, because I need to figure out why didn't that work, so that I can find out how we can get to the root cause and how we can resolve this pain, because that's what I'm always after, is resolving patients' pain so that they can get back to doing what they love to do or just start having a better quality of life. So I hope that answered your question from Instagram. And if you guys have any questions, hit me up in the comment section below. And I want to thank you all for listening. If you could, like, subscribe, and I'll check you guys later.